Presented to you by John Reamer of Ameriprise Financial, a proud sponsor of the Among the Wild film project. Be brilliant.
YCE Radio, coming to you from the icebox of the nation.
Negative 30 degrees on your Sunday afternoon, but there's this massive warm front coming our way, and you know what that means.
Snow!
Yeah, I heard that. Winter storm, just in time for them out-of-towners. They're planning to race down the snowmobile trail over by Cary Park.
Oh, yeah, I heard about them crazy folk. Think they'll be having an SUV division?
Now, what's wrong with a perfectly good snowmobile?
I'm Bonnie Mobeck, and I'm from Lakeville, Minnesota. I'm 45 years old, and I'm married, and I have four kids. This is my first time taking on Arrowhead. I'm going to be riding a fat bike, a 907, and I've got a lot of gear, and I'm excited.
Hey, Andre.
Hey.
How are you, man?
Good.
Good morning.
Okay, now turn Epic's, turn your headset off.
This is my butt. He's gonna kick my ass.
I know.
Ass
turn yours on and turn yours off.
Okay.
Here we are at the Arrowhead 135. It's very early in the morning. These guys are just preparing to go. Of course, this is Epic Bill Bradley and one doggy.
One doggy.
Yes.
My name is Mark Scotch. I'm 57. I'm cross-country skiing the race. And my goal is to just beat my time from last year.
I'll never do anything like this. It'd be fun to try.
Well, I always thought it'd be fun to ski all day.
Yeah.
It's like, Well, how about all day and all night? All day and all night.
Good morning. I got to check in with home one more time.
I got no idea if the trail's been groomed or not. They kind of do their own thing.
Who are you?
Round, brother. Good luck.
Go get it, buddy.
My name is John Storkamp. I'm 33 years old. I'm from Hastings, Minnesota. This is my eighth year participating in the Arrowhead 135.
Yeah, I know. It's like I stripped a layer and packed it because it's like, you know, if you're not cold at the start, you're gonna be roasted.
You know, it seems like the nail in the coffin for just about anyone that's ever come to this race is if you think you're gonna come here and win it, or you think you're gonna come and compete, usually that's a sign that you're gonna drop out and you know, suffer some misery out there. It's really the perfect storm. I mean, it's not any one of the individual elements by itself that conspires to make it so difficult. It's everything put together.
Yeah, yep.
lights, toasty warm this morning.
It's fraught with challenges. It's self-supported. You don't have people walking up to you at, you know, water stops and saying, you know, here's a bunch of food, here's a bunch of water, take this with you. You know, you've got to get off your bike. You've got to, you know, dig through your pack. You've got to find your food. You got to try to figure out how you're going to defrost it, whether that means you're going to stick a frozen, you know, Cliff bar next to your chest and, you know, hope it defrosts soon.
I knew it!
The course and what you're going against in this race is relentless. It goes on and on and on, and the cold is relentless when it gets cold, and the night is relentless. The days you know, it's like you're going through a tunnel like this, and can you still do everything you need to do when you're at 15% capacity? So let the wind blow
on. Three, two, release the hound!
Nope. I see it dark. I see my headlight on my bike casting a bright light, and I turn on that front lamp. You know, it makes like a visual tunnel. You know, so you feel like you're riding through a tunnel of light that's piercing the darkness. And so I see that. I see a lot of frigidity around me. The trees are cold and they're hard. You know, the ground is cold and it's hard and it's unforgiving. And I see myself alone.
Some of my friends in the mountain biking community, my younger friends, you know, 23 years younger than me, they just don't know why I'm so driven. And I say, well, could be my last one, you know, could be. And they said, well, it could be ours too. I said, well, then, you know, don't make any excuses, you know, just get out there and do it.
Well, ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. Ain't no grave hold my body down. Hear that trumpet sound. You're gonna get up out the ground. Ain't no grave hold my body down.
About 3 months prior to the race, I ended up with pretty severe pneumonia. I ended up in the ER, and of course the doctors were concerned about me doing the race because of the harsh conditions on my lungs. What they say is that for every week of training that you miss, it sets you back 2 weeks. So at that point, I was set back about 6 months.
Great day for the Minnesota Northwest.
Good job.
Yeah, you too.
You have to live outside of your comfort zone if you really, really want to do all the things that you're thinking about doing. So don't just dream outside of it, go outside of it.
Caught you a little quicker this year.
Oh, yeah. I won't see you again.
Mile three,
I can hardly stand you. My life, pretty much everyone's life that I know, is filled with nothing but comfort. From the time I wake up in a heated house, with carpet, with plumbing. It's 2 days of my life of hardship. It's self-imposed, you know, other people live with it.
Hey. How's it going?
Nothing's free today.
Good job. It's pretty soft. It's soft for me too, but worse for the bikes.
Yeah.
But yeah, they're having a hard time. But even on the downhills, I'm not going fast. I mean, I got work to go. Even I got to kick it down there. My original plan was not to wax, but I don't have really good glide, to be honest with you. So I thought, what the hell, I might as well try it. Because with the hills coming up, if I get good glide, I think that's really going to pay off, you know?
Boy, timed it just right, didn't I? No water left in there.
See you out there, Mark.
Yep, see you guys out there.
Good job. Good luck.
Way to go. Way to go, Mark.
Thanks, Jennifer.
We're going to have to tape that for sure. Oh, it just catches your rear tire and you're just, you know, sliding everywhere, and it's pretty rough, you know. It's definitely a hard race, absolutely.
John's a legend. I think he's probably a four-time Arrowhead champion, at least. And he's a machine.
You're making it perfect.
I don't know, it felt like it was misting for quite a while. And it seems like it just stopped, which is really quite good. Hey, John.
How's it going, John?
Good, how are you?
Good luck, John. See you in a while.
It's slow, man. I can't believe how long it took to get here.
Yeah.
You just can't run in it. You can't. Oh, snowshoeing. That's kind of nice.
It looks to me like it's going to be mostly snow instead of liquid precipitation, I'm hoping. Because if it rains much, it's going to be pretty tough for folks out there.
It's cold outside, but there's one thing missing. The sky is gray and the wind is hissing. I can see my breath, I can feel it coming. When it falls from the sky, I'm gonna hit the ground running. I got no money left with no grass to mow. That's why I'm praying for snow.
I'm starting to feel a little anxious to get out of here, you know?
Conditions are better. From the start to Gateway wasn't great at all for skiers, I don't care what they say. It was soft, it was work. I mean, I was working my ass off. But then after Gateway, it's been just beautiful. I was just talking to Matt Maxwell, he's a second place skier. He's got combi skis where he can skate or classic, and he said it's really getting bad out there for skating. So I'm gonna have issues with my tips.
Issues and mechanical problem, two mechanical problems, and then just a boatload of snow. We were pushing our bikes for the last 8 hours, so it was pretty brutal. So my riding partner ended up with an injury, and then I got stuck in a single gear. So I couldn't ride anyways, and then both my lights went out. So I was trying to ride in his light, and that wasn't working. So I got his headlamp, and that only lasted for so long. So he's on his way, and here I am. They're picking up a ton of people. There's a ton of people that are looking for rides. So pretty much half of, at least half of the people that are left. So, yeah. We passed John's store camp. He's about 4 hours out still, and he actually put on his Camelback and didn't seal it, and it just leaked all over him, so he's having a hard time right now.
You're Bonnie, right?
Yeah, okay. And John's about 8 miles out.
John, but he's on foot and he's still moving?
Yeah he's doing fine. Yeah,
okay, good.
Mm-hmm.
So Bonnie's out. What number are you, Bonnie? Just because I don't
18.
Remember. 18. So I can take you off.
It's epic out there.
Yeah? What's it like out there?
Lots and lots of snow.
Yeah? How deep do you think it is?
Oh, before a snow machine went by, it was probably about 2.5 feet or better.
Yeah.
Really tough going. It's a rough Arrowhead.
How fast do you think you're traveling out there?
Oh, I was probably traveling maybe 2 miles an hour, maybe.
I've gotten here at 2:30 in the morning before. What time is it? It's 8 o'clock. That's crazy. That's like, let's see here, leave at 5:45. No, leave at 5. And get here at 8. That's 15 hours. To go 35 miles. That's 2. God, it's like 2.25 miles an hour. That is insane. My grandma can walk that fast.
Okay, 107 yeah. is dropping, and 115, you're dropping.
It's, trail is very soft. I'll say 7 inches.
What do you want to eat? You want food first?
No, I better...
Better not?
I better get warm.
Okay. No, she needs to get out to a road. We're, at this point, we cannot go in and sweep for her. We have to take a break. We're telling everyone who needs help, they need to get in their bivy sacks and stay warm. They've got all the equipment they need to keep themselves safe, and that's what they need to do.
You put on a shell, but then it was too hot.
Yeah.
And then you sweat, or you didn't, or you wouldn't wear a shell.
Yeah. Which way do you want to get wet?
And then you get wet the other way. Yeah. And then you can fill up your hydration pack out of your thermos. And the guy who's responsible to close it can, doesn't close it, and you put it on, and it all like runs down your arms and your armpits at 2 a.m.
Ooh, that guy's a dick.
It's in the color of the trees on the highway, brilliant with dying. It's in the dust we're breathing these days, in your whispers and sighing. It's in the longer shadows stretching into the falling night. It's in the deep red sun that's setting. Oh, we're ready, blazing out of sight.
Ready?
Hey Brian, you want to help?
Gotta put on my pseudo scuba gear.
So, are you gonna continue?
Yeah. It's probably the quickest way to get back at this point. That's about all I thought about for the last 5 hours. I kept waiting for some snowmobile to come by. Any snowmobile. I'd be like, okay, I'm gone. Just take me somewhere. Not one. I didn't see one snowmobile since I left Mill George. None. Zero. 12 hours. No snowmobile.
Yeah, about mile 103, I started throwing up. Tried to go for another mile, and then it was bad. So I just pulled out my bivy and slept. I don't know. I'm going to wait here a little bit and see if I can put some more food in. Every time I try and put food in my mouth, I just got to spit it out because I'm going to puke it up.
Skated since Mill George. I mean, I didn't see a snowmobile till noon. The trail was pristine and it was snow up to my knees almost. Oh, oh Jesus. Any lower? I mean, if it's groomed at all, if I can skate, you know, I'll probably be in about midnight. But if it's not, I have no idea. I don't know. I don't think I've done anything this hard.
Wow. What's it look like in there, Dallas?
It looks like heaven.
Shit, there's beds in here.
And Doritos.
Wind looks like it's going to stay the same.
Good job. Good stuff.
Yep.
I'm tired. For some reason.
Yeah. I think I can feel my feet.
They feel so weird once I step on the skis.
Take
those
skis off? That's gotta feel bizarro.
Yeah, it feels like I don't have any feet.
Yeah.
Howdy, how can we help you out?
How's it going?
Good, how are you doing?
Great.
What number are you?
105.
105? Alright.
Yes, sir.
said, stop me if you've ever heard this before. Stop me if you've ever heard this one before.
For me, coming up against something that's hard, something that takes a lot of effort, you know, and focus, something that presents obstacles that you have to, you know, overcome, is part of the reward.
The trail is just an avenue. It's just a pathway for me, and you know, the race and the trail and these kind of things are just something that's handed to you from the gift giver, and it's just a gift.
Strength, endurance, solitude, and survival. And I think that sums it up.